Good morning, everyone, and happy weekend. This is Doc Stout, back with Murlocs Invade Naxxramas. I am going to take my Warlock Murloc deck today back into the Plague Quarter to face off against a Loatheb.
Nearby Loatheb causes your flesh to rot, so I recommend a melee class.
Loatheb's ability for 2 mana is to deal 3 damage directly to me in a necrotic aura. Now, that seems pretty generic. It looks like a slightly better version of the Hunter Hero ability. So, whether or not this is difficult, it's all dependent on the cards that they've put in Loatheb's deck. Let's see what we've got. First attempt. I am currently running pure Murloc. No spiders at the moment. We'll see how removal-heavy the deck is.
Loatheb!
I see you.
Your soul shall be mine!
We've seen some of these decks have custom cards that I was completely unaware of. Yeah, this is fine. I'd prefer a one drop, but maybe I'll get lucky and pull one off the top. Well, that's a one drop, just not one that's immediately useful. 75 life. Okay, now we've discovered what's unique about this encounter. All right. It's a 1-3. I think the best thing to do is just play the Leper Gnome and pass turn. Yikes. Alright. I guess we'll get yet another card. Soulfire will actually, let's not use a Soulfire just yet. Sacrifice a Bluegill Warrior to be able to start again next turn. Alright, this looks a little better. Make a ton of Murlocs. And since none of them have haste, we pass the turn. Spore Burst. A board wipe. How about that? Huh.
Put this apple on your head.
That's a battle cry. That's no good. Yuck. Yeah, that didn't do very much. I'm just gonna lose him before he does anything. So, surprised by a Spore Burst. Still not useful. I guess we go here. Hope to get lucky. And I guess attack here directly.
The end is close.
Okay, that sucks. So it looks like the trick here trick here is to just die. Alright, Spore Burst is going to be a big problem. It does kind of replicate the encounter in the MMO, where you gotta pop the spores as best you can to buff your damage to DPS down the boss before he overwhelms you. That's pretty sweet.
Gul'dan!
So I simultaneously have to try not to overextend.
I see you.
Your soul shall
and
be mine.
Make sure I pop the spores. Cold Light Seer is actually not very good at all. Yeah, this is a much better starting hand, though it does not have enough Murloc. Huh. I just hate not playing a Tidecaller on turn one.
I feel itchy.
Job's done.
Yeah, okay. I guess we go. Pint size summoner and pass. Yeah, it looks like all of the effects here are, if I can manage to kill the creatures, things get better for me. Yeah, that's fine. Play a Tidecaller, draw a card.
Job done.
Will that be enough? Yeah, that looks like that'll be enough. Yeah, I guess I just gotta keep working at it. And I guess I pass. Okay, that's...
I feel icky!
Sweet Mortal Coil. Play a Murloc Raider. Bluegill Warrior. Gotta take that thing out. This is a much more deliberate pace than I like to be. Huh. If I silence that one, I guess I attack first. Then silence that one, I think. No, that didn't help. That was actually the opposite of what I wanted to do. So I took the buff away from myself. That was terrible. Alright.
The end is close.
Okay, we won't do that again. Definitely need to draw a card.
Put this apple on your head.
It's not actually very useful in this situation since none of my guys have haste. Alright, well, we'll see what happens from here. Okay, that's a taunter. That's no big deal. Three to me, that's fine. I don't care about any of that. Oh, wow, my guys just immediately get that, too. So I guess we'll get more health. Insulate me against Spore Burst a little bit. Nice. Who do I care about the least in this situation? Actually, I probably care the least about the Murloc Scout. Play another knife juggler. And hit for a ton of damage. Alright, I'm feeling like I'm in pretty good shape right now. Although, we haven't seen all of the cards in this deck yet. This is kind of interesting because... Alright, there's a lot of ways I can win in this situation. But let's go for the most stylish. Let's give him power overwhelming. And then shadow flame him. And then let's just swing in with a 19-3 Murloc Tidehunter for the win. Yeah, pop on those spores. Yeah. Yeah, popping those spores proved to be important.
Stop it! Stop it right this minute!
I think it didn't register with me that that boost to power was permanent off those spores. Got a couple of sludge belchers for the deck. Probably not anything I'd ever use with Murlocs. Like, five is way too many mana. But this also completes the quarter and is going to unlock all sorts of modes. And we get our reward for completing the plague quarter. A copy of Loatheb. 5-5 for 5. Enemy spells cost 5 more this turn. And we have a mage challenge and looks like a hunter challenge. Which I will be back with probably tomorrow or the next day. Look for that in the next couple of days. So, yeah. I feel pretty good about this. That was a fun encounter. That's going to do it for today. Before the next wing opens, I will be doing heroic attempts, buffeted on each side by class challenges until the next wing opens, when we'll take a look at the military quarter. But until then... thanks for tuning in to watch the Murlocs continue to roll through Naxxramas towards Kel'Thuzad. This is Doc Stout, and I'm going to tune out now. Murgle on, my friends.